From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sabol. The Penobscot County Sheriff's Department is looking for a missing 15-year-old girl from Glenburn. Today, authorities say Nicole Cable was last seen by her parents Sunday evening. They say 45 officers from different agencies are working to locate her. Law enforcement officials, joined by Cable's parents at a news conference, declined to say Monday if she's in danger or if she had run away before. No Amber Alert was issued. Her mother says that she was scheduled to meet someone that she had met on Facebook. The Maine Warden Service dive team has recovered the bodies of two men whose snowmobiles crashed through the ice on Rangeley Lake last winter. Officials say the dive team used side-scan sonar to locate the bodies late this morning in 60 feet of water. Then divers brought them to the surface. Wardens think the remains are those of 40-year-old Ken Henderson and 41-year-old John Spencer. Divers recovered the body of a third man, 43-year-old Glenn Henderson, last week. The three men are believed to have gone through the water on the same night a Yarmouth woman was killed when she accidentally rode her snowmobile onto the partially frozen lake. Convicted killer Jason Tortis is asking for a new trial for the third time. His case is before the state Supreme Court today. He is serving a 38-year prison sentence for killing nursing student Kelly Gorham in her Alfred home back in 2007. Tortis strangled Gorham and then buried her on his father's property in Stewartstown, New Hampshire. Prosecutors said Tortis was upset over their broken engagement, but his attorneys argued that he deserves a new trial because there are two alternate suspects who emerged after his trial. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sabol. We'll be right back.